You had mentioned a milk drink, that you said you put yogurt and a little bit of milk and you mix.
No, yogurt and water.
Oh, water. Okay, what's water?
Lassi
you can say, but buttermilk is different. Lassi is very homogenized. It is thick. Buttermilk is like water.
So it's water. And is there anything else you just, the yogurt and the water?
You can put a little bit of cumin, pepper, salt. Salt I don't recommend most times, but if you have had a very heavy meal, salt can kill you.
Okay, thank you.
I'm sorry, I had that milk. I didn't know that's what it was when I was in India, with the cumin and stuff, and I took a big swig, and it was not what I expected.
Did you think you were having something sweet?
I thought I was having milk. Okay. And so,
sour, cumin.
Exactly, all that. I'm like,
so delicious. Yes. I have another question.
Yeah, sure.
You had talked about something before that if you knew it was gonna, or like what you were talking about, meat, and so that they have drinks that you, like a spirit that you could drink, and then it feels lighter. And my family is vegetarian, and so we do eat beans maybe once or twice a week. And so I wondered if there was something that was similar, not a spirit maybe, but something else that you would recommend to eat with a bean to help with the gas or the bloating.
As I always say, that whenever you eat beans and all, always use cumin.
Cumin, yeah, I think so too.
Yes. Use cumin, it will be fine. Rest, beans are such, they are such, I can never quantify them, how they act. So I always tell my clients to avoid them.
Okay.
So probably but since you're using it once and twice, you should not make a problem. But see to it that, you put good amount of cumin in it. Salt should be in a much proper way. Once you're making those beans, add the salt before you steam them or do that, and then use them. Don't salt them.
Yeah.
A lot of people salt them. That is the worst thing you could do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And use lime. Little bit of lime is always better with the beans.
Okay.
Can you talk a little bit about combining like food? Are there any like things that you should not eat? Like you said, of course, cheese or dairy and meat don't go together.
See, it is not like you cannot eat dairy and meat. It is thing in which context you are doing. Sometimes when you cook dairy with meat, it is fine. We have seen it, Like when you read the Bible or you read this, you see Jesus had a baked fish with milk. We find his references. So nothing is wrong. Only thing when you're doing it in a very, very curtailed manner, like you're eating something and then you're drinking ice cream over it, or you're eating fish and you're having milk over it, or eating some seafood and having milk, it will cause you a problem. So there are always, we say, don't combine fruit with milk. A lot of time you have these fruit shakes, don't have it. It will cause you a lot of skin problems. Only fruit which you can have with milk is a mango.
A melon, you said?
Mango. Yeah.
Mango.
So avoid having those fruit shakes if you're having it regularly. Occasionally it doesn't make a difference. But something which you're making a part of your day-to-day meal, avoid having this. If you don't drink milk with meat, milk with fruits, then I don't remember much of this, but as I said, that these are the main prominent what we always tell, that because this is something which I see regularly, that people have this milk and fruit, milk and things, milkshakes, fruit shakes. So those things basically you should avoid. Rest I think so fine. Occasionally if you cook something, there are a lot of cuisines which cook in milk and all, it is fine. So that adaptation sometimes is fine. Don't mix jaggery with milk. I've told you this jaggery, never use it with milk as a sweetener. It will cause you problems. So those things, do not eat curd at night, yogurt, it will cause you problems. A lot of people eat this yogurt at night and go to sleep because they have nothing. You get this flavored yogurt, eat it at night and go to sleep sometime. Don't do that. It will cause you kidney problems, it will cause you swellings, your autoimmune. So those certain things you should always avoid. But if you follow this pattern which I have told you, maybe these all things would not matter.
You mentioned rice. My husband's a diabetic, and you said that if you cook it a certain way, it's low glycemic.
See, it is not about glycemic index. In diabetes, what we fail to understand, that diabetes has got nothing to do with direct sugars. Diabetes is inability to synthesize sugars. So if your body is unable to synthesize sugar, even if you give it bitter gum, you give it fenugreek, it will still spike diabetes. The whole concept is to enable the body to synthesize sugars. Killing the sugar is no use. What we do with insulin and we do with this metformin or salicylates is that we try to, petroleum sulfates is that we try to reduce the blood sugar in the blood streams, the sugar in the stream. But that is starving your cells from sugar, because sugar or glycogen, what we call, sugar is not sweet, glycogen is your powerhouse. So everything requires it to function. What is happening is that the body's inability to convert whatever food it is there into glycogen. Initially starts with certain foods like sugars and all, which are direct source of it. Then eventually even the indirect sources do not get converted, because the insulin ceases to function. So this entire method what you use is important. In that methods if you use and everything is getting synthesized, then if you cook this in a better way, it won't cause a problem. So that has to be understood in a longer sense of how exactly the diabetes is progressed. Lot of time till you get sugars in urine, I do not consider it as of grave disorder. Only like hyperglycemia in the blood, it can be due to lot of many factors. Mostly it happens through inflammation. So by just doing these changes, what I told, eating on time, sleeping on time, within 10-15 days will bring your sugar levels down. Then slowly but surely you can eat. Once the inflammation reduces, most of the disorders get cured. It's not a rocket science. It is there. It is not like big thing. Rest it depends, because we are unable to give up these things. That is the reason we try to find this low glycemic, high glycemic. I like rice, but I cannot have high glycemic, so I have low glycemic, nothing. White rice is as much good, even better than brown rice. Because most of the white rice and basmati is a very low glycemic content. But a lot of people say, I should not have white rice. I should have everything that is brown. Brown rice can cause you diabetes if it is not digested properly. We used to see, it is written in Ayurveda, don't believe. Now the experiment has been done on it. Just search white rice versus brown rice and it will come to me. So it is not about this. If you go on looking for calories, if you go on looking for glycemic content, then it is a completely different science. But you cannot quantify it, because body doesn't use calories in that way. You say putting one gram of magnesium, 1 gram of iron, body doesn't synthesize it. Iron requires magnesium, copper requires zinc. If zinc is down, copper will grow up. Copper is up, zinc will go down. So that symbiosis is required, and that symbiosis can only come if the food is synthesized properly. Taking the supplements might not do it. I have seen people who are taking calcium supplements and they develop stones. So it is not synthesized. So that synthesis will only occur if this balance of digestion is not.
So is there any like supplement or herb that you would suggest for anyone just to...
It depends. You know, as I said, these things what you have done are more than enough. Apart from that, like as I said, for women the fenugreek or sometimes use of cumin, more than enough. You don't require anything else. Apart from that, if you have some kind of a disorder, you are suffering from something which has already manifested, then it could be looked upon in that way. But just for general guidelines, at first thing, follow the timelines. Eat on time, sleep on time. That is the first thing what you can do. Water use and use of salt and no use of sugar. If these four things you do properly, 80% of your disorders will go. Rest, spices comes much later. Of course, they are useful, very beneficial. But if this base is created, they will add to your experience.
Something still, let's say, war or whatever. So let's say if I was making steaming vegetables or something like that, so put the salt
just in. Before you put it on the stove or on the flame.
Okay, right, exactly, which is while it's still cold, that's all.
That's
all. Okay.
Let it cook, because the impurities go with it.
Right.
Because salt has got a lot of impurities.
Yes.
When you cook it, only the essence gets absorbed. The impurities go. When you put salt from above, the kidney has to throw it out. And always use, as I said, natural salts. These free flow salts contain aluminium silicate. If you take out the hygroscopic nature from salt, then it is not salt. Salt has to snatch moisture from the surroundings. If you make salt not salt like by making those free flow salt, you get this free flow salt, right? Which doesn't absorb moisture. You can just sprinkle it around. You get a lot of these free flow salts. Don't use those salts. Like your table salt, this free flow, you can put to your hand and it won't swell anything. It will just be like that. You just throw it, you can see salt. Uh-huh. We don't even remember that it is a modified salt. We call it is a natural salt. It cannot be natural because you cannot make salt unhygroscopic without adding aluminium silicate. So that aluminium you are giving to your child, they are going to develop this autism, autistic traits, this traits is as good as vaccines. Because vaccines contain aluminium.
Can you say something about allergies? Like what are your thoughts on allergies? What makes people allergic, or how to treat, or how to diagnose?
See, this lies on the same foundation. First thing is to understand if you are doing these things right. Allergies are nothing but incompatibilities of your immune system. As I said, in life has got nothing to do with the emotional financial problem. It has to sustain itself. So it will sustain its heart, liver, kidney, brain. Even getting up from here and going to the toilet is a luxury. If my body cannot support, I'll do it here. We have seen in a lot of people who are bedridden. So allergies are trying to tell you that your body is not compatible with your stimulus, with your surroundings. So you are doing something which is not making your blood strong. Your blood should be strong. And the strong, I mean not call it quantitatively strong, qualitatively strong. If you check the blood levels of women working on fields anywhere around the world, their blood level will always be low than you and me. If you see a person who is perfectly healthy, so-called healthy, and you check his blood levels, he will be normal. But he has got all the disorders. You know, he is having obesity, he is having this. And those women are working 3 times better than me and you. So is your blood providing you the nutrition? Is it qualitative? Is it circulating all the things? And when it is not doing, you will be susceptible to allergies. The moment the season changes, you will get cold and cough. You will get hives. You will get whatever it is. Why in the same family not everyone gets it? Only one person gets if it is environmental influence. Why a mother cooking the same food and feeding it to 3 children, they accept it differently. Someone will eat the entire plate, someone will throw it away, and someone will not even look at it. It is the same food, it is the same organs, it is the same genetics. How it is absorbed, excreted and assimilated is different. So it doesn't matter what, where you are. You have to understand this. And when you keep these things constant, then probably 70-80% they won't suffer from anything. If apart from that something has gone wrong in some terms of allergies, then certain medical interventions in terms of good practitioners you can work out. But this has to be worked out on an independent scale. You have to do some changes which will transcend these things. You cannot take medicines to suppress the allergy, whether it be herbal or chemical. You'll still be dependent on that medicine, and it is of no use. That change in your diet has to be made. If the salt has to be given up, it has to be given up. You cannot reduce it. Reduction is just a figment of imagination. You are taking 4 cigarettes a day, I am smoking 1, so I have reduced. You are still taking 1. So body is still reacting to that smoke. So either you give it up or you develop an ability to smoke an entire pack. You cannot reduce something. It is just a placebo. So when we say I have reduced, I have cut down on this, I have cut down on that. You don't cut down, you abstain. If you feel it is a problem. That changes lot of people are unable to make, and therefore they suffer from diseases.
I have a question. What can you do to help hot flashes?
During the menopause, what are coming next time?
Yeah.
See, as I said, when you are getting lot of hot flashes, that means that you are not arriving a proper menopause.
Okay.
That means the heat in your body has not been regulated well. So you can't do much. As I said, you know, have this fenugreek seeds, eat on time, sleep on time, and during whenever if your menses are available during those 3 days of menses, go off salt. Have a lot of papaya. It's a very good cleanser. If you do it very well, I think so within 1 or 2 menstrual cycles this will be gone. But this has to be started much earlier. But right now if you do it, it is fine. So first thing is to go on this protocol.
Let's say you crave certain foods. Should you eat what you're craving?
Most of the times it is a pointer that when you crave certain foods, eat it. But then understand what the craving is about.
Right.
So if you're craving for meat, then you understand, and if it's a constant craving which is coming, that means your body cannot do without it. So create a sustainable approach to include it in your diet. But if you have some reservations around it, then you have to work out a way around. There is never a way around a natural process.
Yeah, no, I mean.
So that is something which appeals because our mind is, as I said, we go in the Vidyan Mein Kosha, we try to manipulate our emotions towards the stimulus around us. We make all these choices. So that is a personal domain which I don't want to enter. So I can only take from a logical point of view that if you are craving something, means your body requires it. Sometimes the cravings are there, sometimes the cravings come when you have been addicted to something and you are leaving it. Like a lot of time when I put people on protocols, you suddenly want to go into a proper diet. The first thing your body will crave for is sugar if you are a woman, not a male, woman. Why? Because your body cannot digest sugar. The moment you eat sugar, it gets converted into flame and goes and sits in your uterus. Once it sits in your uterus, the egg starts starve of blood. The egg starve of blood, they start swelling. And you get all these emotional functional quotient. So the moment you start going off sugar, you'll first start craving sugar. You'll feel cry, you'll require. That is the reason why women eat chocolates when they are depressed. Why? Because you have adapted your body to it. So once that goes, it is a good, then you will settle down. So those small things which you are linearly adapted, because when you are born in a family and certain things you pick up, you are not aware of it. You grow with it. They might be right or they might be wrong because you do not choose your parents. A person whose body is adapted to vegetarianism can be born in a family who are completely non-vegetarian and she will get all the inflammatory disorders. You won't know because hey, everyone is eating. Why aren't you eating? A completely person who craves meat can be born in a family who have suddenly turned vegetarian. So he'll also get problems, but they'll never be aware of it because we don't choose our parents. We are just a constitution born somewhere, some genetics are affecting, but eventually it is your individual constitution. And that is the reason why we see these problems in law. So you should, and that is what Ayurveda is all. When you talk about constitution, that is what it is all about. It understanding your cravings on a platform. That platform is this eating on time, sleeping on time, cutting off a lot of factors, and then introspecting what I really want. And then you build on it. Then there are so many choices in the world which you can create. If you have to eat meat this way, that way, eat. So I myself think that don't keep any reservations. Whatever are your reservations, are your fundamental, religious, practice-based, social-based, moral-based reservations. So when you come into this, I'll tell you what is required by you. Ideally, what you can transcend or not depends upon how quickly you will get all right or not. If you can't do a particular thing, you will still get all right, but it will take that much more time. If you accept it naturally, you will get all right quickly because that's how your body is made up of. So that's something which you have to introspect and see when these cravings come up.